Hello, welcome to the highlights of the seventh Benson Hedges World Series Cup game. This one between New Zealand and Sri Lanka at Belrive Oval in Hobart. The first time it's been used for a big match after its rejuvenation. It looks very good. Fine conditions here and a promised temperature of around about 34 degrees. That should be good for the batsmen, perhaps not quite so for the bowlers, but there will be a sea breeze during the day. The teams for this match, first of all, New Zealand have problems. John Bracewell is out with a back injury. Martin Sneddon injured his back yesterday at practice when he bent over to pick up a ball. Just shows you how easily that can be done. And Andrew Jones is out because of that finger injury he sustained in the match at the Adelaide Oval the other day. Philip Horn is 12th man, and Ian Smith, the wicketkeeper, is in. We don't know at this moment if he's going to keep wickets or whether that job will be done by Tony Blaine, who showed himself to be such a good cricketer in the doubleheader match at Adelaide Oval at the weekend. The Sri Lankan side, predictably, they've kept the same team there. The spin will be done by Asoka De Silva and Aravinda De Silva. They have Ravi Ratnayake, Graham LeBroy. They have Rumanaika and Ranatunga to bowl medium pace. And perhaps Guru Singha might even get on and bowl a few overs of medium pace himself. Well, Bill Lawrie reported that the pitch for this first encounter at Belrive was in very good shape. He did have the feeling, though, that there might be some movement off the seam. We pick it up now in the sixth over. 13 runs are on the board. Medium pacer Graham LeBroy is coming in to bowl to Ken Rutherford, the New Zealand opener. Your commentators are Ian Chappell and Max Walker.
It's nicely timed by Ken Rutherford, the first boundary of the morning for New Zealand.
Of extra bounce here. And this wicket is one of instant turf, similar to that of the MCG.
It's going to be Ravi Ratnayake to continue. Off the bat and just wide of the keeper, and it'll beat Rumanaika to the boundary. First boundary for John Wright this morning.
Using the swing, Ravi Ratnayake. Good shot this one, just outside the line of the pads. Enough bat to beat the keeper. Would have been a magnificent performance to lay a glove on that one. So runs at last coming along.
Con. First man out is John Wright. First blood to the Sri Lankans, and that, I think, can be directly attributed to the fact that the batsmen have been so frustrated by this Sri Lankan attack that eventually they've decided to try and go over the top.
It's excellent bowling. Last three or four overs, they've kept their ball on the length spot on. Wright trying to clear the infield. Doesn't beat mid off. It's a safe catch. And John Wright is out. It's 1 for 29.
Now Jeff Crowe, man who's been out of touch but not out of sorts. He's retained a good, happy countenance all the way through, but he's had plenty of disappointment so far on this tour. The Australian bowlers troubled him in the test matches, and the same has happened with Australia and Sri Lanka in these games. He's come in now on a pitch where the ball is doing quite a bit. If he gets run out, that really will be the end of things. And that's what's happened to him. Well, when you're having a bad trot, nothing at all will go right. It needed to be a direct hit, but it was one of the risky singles you could imagine. Well, this is what the umpire saw. Give you an idea of how difficult a decision it would have been for the umpire. He was in good position, but that is the speed at which everything happens as far as the umpire is concerned. Jeff Crowe out for a duck. 2 for 32. New batsman for New Zealand is Martin Crowe. First ball to Martin Crowe, and he extracts a little revenge and picks up four. Now a look at Geoff Crowe, Gurusinghe coming in, picking up and throwing down the stumps. Well, Mel Johnson was in perfect position there.
Bemanai. He's hit that one way down towards mid-wicket. Martin Crowe's adopted a tactic here which would suggest that he's decided it's going to be over the top today. That's the third occasion he's done exactly that in various directions. Very good player, Martin Crowe. The wicket certainly has quite a lot of life in it. He's adopted the policy that he's going to get the bowlers before they get him. Once again, zips it over the top, this time of mid-wicket. Little squarer, much the same direction, and into the boundary for four. It's going to be Runatunga to continue.
And he's out.
Yes, he's bowled him, trying to pull away. Kept a fraction low. Sri Lanka right in this match. Rutherford clean bowled, trying to hit through mid-wicket. Didn't appear to bounce that much. Just took the off stump. And that's a great breakthrough.
Yes, well, Runatunga doing the damage. New Zealand now 3 for 67.
Deepak Patel comes to the wicket. New Zealand in a little bit of trouble here in Hobart. 3 for 67. It's gone, yes! That's a great court, good captaincy. Slipman brought in. Julie Runatunga found the outside edge. That was well caught. Excellent cricket by Mudigali. Brought the slipper in, got the result.
Mudigali has been prepared to have an attack in the field right from the start this morning. And that was a very good catch. Runatunga just showing a little bit of movement. Backed up with good line and length, can be very, very effective. So Daddles the duck walks off with Deepak Patel. New Zealand 4 for 67.
Tony Wayne, the hero of New Zealand's win in Adelaide. Strides the wicket with his side at 4 for 67. Arjuna Runatunga getting the ball to move away. Patel offering the outside edge. Aravinda De Silva taking a good catch. Sri Lankans, very happy team at the moment.
What a great combination. One little man bowling it and a great little pair of soft hands grabbing the catch at second slip.
Champaka Ramanaika.
It's gone! The great Martin Crowe's gone. Caught behind. Good piece of bowling. Ramanaika, he's excited. They're all excited. Good catch. Roddy Oliver's taking a good catch, coming away to his right. This crowd here roaring at Hobart. Sri Lankans have New Zealand reeling.
And on the run, the best of the recognised batsmen now back in the dressing room. All they can do is watch with Crowe out. What a catch, Guy Dalvies. And Rampaka Ramanaika, what a great change in his career. On Saturday, his first two overs cost him 22 runs, and here he is doing some damage at Belrive Oval. New Zealand 5 for 70.
Richard Hadley is the new batsman.
Well played. Richard Hadley with years of experience. Looking the ball over the infield. Superbly timed shot.
It's almost 100 one-day internationals behind this shot. No one out there. Still a fairly attacking field. And Hadley, a little bit of a gamble. Pays off.
Gurusinghe. Tony Blaine really taking hold of that short delivery.
Blaine will be much happier with this shot. Really was a loosening up delivery. Dropped just halfway down the wicket.
Gurusinghe persists in bowling too short.
giving New Zealand a chance to get back into this match. The odds were certainly in Sri Lanka's favour. They won't be for too much longer if Gurasinghe persists in bowling there.
77-run partnership so far between Blaine and Hadley. Picked up beautifully. There's 81 coming up.
Yes, that is a lovely shot there. A couple of men back on the leg side, and so it has to be hit pretty well, and the placement has got to be right too. All of that was in place here. Lofting it up into the air, but also into the gap. So the 150 up of 272 balls.
Hadley's gone for the big one. It's very well placed. Two fielders rushing towards it, neither able to make it in time.
Yes, if you're not going to clear the fence, you've got to make sure you lob the ball into the gaps, and that's exactly what Hadley did there. A couple of the Sri Lankans converging on that one as it bounced into the fence. So Blaine has moved to 34 now, and Richard Hadley is just one short of his half century. We're into over number 46. So just five overs to go of the Sri Lankan innings. New Zealand put into bat by Sri Lanka. 5 for 157. That's Mudugalli, their captain, with his favourite little white floppy hat with the little air vents on the side. That's his half century. So Richard Hadley posting a very good 50 in 62 balls. Only two boundaries, but it's been a very valuable knock.
This could be out. It's gone. Oh, that's what Sri Lanka needed. They needed a wicket. Ravi Ratnaika breaks through once again. Substitute fieldsman takes the catch. Hadley out for 52.
Yes, well, a great performance. Fine half century comes to an end. Unselfish knock, caught just on the edge of the 30-metre circle. So Hadley now departs. New Zealand 6 for 165.
Ian Smith playing his first match in the competition following the injury to his finger. Test match in Melbourne. That was a good innings by Hadley. Didn't quite clear the infield on that occasion, but he's put his side back on course. Graham O'Broy to continue, three overs remaining. It's a chance for a run out, this could be close. And he misses. Well, they've knocked the stumps over once or twice. Mahanama, fine fieldsman. And all three stumps to knock down on this occasion.
Picked up, had a bit of time too. Would have been out by half a track. Well, you can't hit them every time. A little bit of pressure, the situation.
It's well fielded, not a goalie. My word, they've lifted their standard in the field. They've been under pressure as far as their bowling has been concerned throughout this series, but their fielding the last two or three games has lifted 100%.
It's the key fieldsman inside the circle. Mudugalli is one of them. He run that one down beautifully on his right.
It's well placed. It's the way to go. McGroy just straying onto the leg stump. Smith picked that up beautifully.
It's at this stage of the game, very familiar sight. The tug through mid-wicket. So the two New Zealand keepers at the crease now, Tony Blaine Ian Smith.
In the air. Well, he's going for it, Mahanama. Good boy, fine catch. Running with the ball is the keeper aside. He has fielded superbly. That is a classic outfield catch. Beautifully judged, running with the ball, never panicked, a gem.
Very good talking too by the Sri Lankans. That was a very high ball. Man with the gloves generally would be looking to it. Guy Dalvis, obviously he's called. He sets off after it. But you watch Mahanama, there could have been a very heavy collision here. He didn't take his eye off the ball. And as Bill Lawrie said, certainly a classic catch. New Zealand 7 for 179.
Stuart Gillespie is the next batsman for New Zealand.
Roshan Mahanama has had a wonderful series. He showed no fear. He kept his eye on the ball. I'm sure he was distracted just for a moment by the wicketkeeper coming in. Beautifully judged. Ravi Ratnayake. On good line length. Recipe goes up. It could be gone. No, he finds a gap. And finds the rope as well. For a run, 7 for 189. Six balls remaining. Playing on 44. Westby 6. So far, LeBroy is bowled without control. Well bowled and it's well played. What a superb shot. Moving away to the onside. Crashed it square. Beautifully timed.
LeBroy did everything right then. He pitched about middle and off stump. Not quite the leg side. Perhaps not quick enough. But the width Bill was talking about, that was obtained by a very innovative approach. Backing away towards square leg. And the result, a very good boundary.
Wayne moves to 48. 48. It's down the ground. Westby should come back. He doesn't. Good throw. Lewisinger. Fine throw. Good outfielder.
Well, Gurasinghe saw that the non-striker's end wasn't the end to go for. The danger end would be down at the keeper's end. Beautifully struck, right in the meat of the bat. Gurasinghe, one of the finest outfielders in the competition at the moment. Beautiful throw.
Gillespie on strike. That's the right thing, he works it square. Good return once again. About enjoying this run chase. I think they'll be quite happy with 200 after being 5 for 70. 7 for 195. That'll give Tony Blaine the strike. Wayne 49. He's played very well. He's a very cool customer, this young man.
There's still maybe two here. They're gambling, they're going, and very well run. Wayne gets two leg byes. Scoreboard keeps ticking over. 200 might be just about what they asked for.
Final delivery, playing on 49. Swing and a miss. Blaine remains not out 49. New Zealand after 50 overs. 7 for 199. good performance after being 5 for 70 in the 24th over. Hadley and Blaine adding 95 runs for that partnership. They steadied the ship. So Sri Lanka will need 200 to win at a run rate of 4 runs per over.
Well, that may not seem many runs, 199, 200 to win for Sri Lanka, but in my opinion, New Zealand did wonderfully well there to get their total up to that figure. John Bracewell, in an interview with Ian Chappell, said they would be well satisfied with 200 for Sri Lanka to chase. That's exactly what has happened. A look at the scorecard now, and the runs in the main came from that splendid partnership between Tony Blaine and Richard Hadley. They added 95 in 140 balls. Now, that in itself is not over fast, but they showed good common sense there. Tony Blaine is looking to be a very, very good cricketer. He made 49 not out, and Hadley 52 from just 65 balls. What a fine cricketer he is. 49 to Blaine from 96 balls. The early part was something of a disaster. 5 down for 70, including Jeff Crowe, who managed to run himself out there. I'm not too sure what else he can do, but things are really grim for him at the moment. 199 for 7 from a full 50 overs. And the bowling figures for Sri Lanka, Ravi Ratnayake, 9 overs, 1 maiden, 3 for 33. He had a good day out there. Graham Le Broy, 43 from 10 overs. But Sri Lanka really suffered from no balls and wides. They're giving the opposition at least 2 extra overs. Champaka Ramanayake, 10 overs, 2 maidens, 1 for 30. Arjuna Ranatunga bowled well today. Little dinky seamers, no great pace there, but enough movement to trouble the batsman. 10 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 34. And Guru Singha, Asoka De Silva and Aravinda De Silva between them bowled 11 overs. So it's 200 to win for the Sri Lankan batting side. As I say, that doesn't seem many, but I think it'll be a really difficult task for them. They have to score at 4 and over, and Richard Hadley and Ewan Chatfield are very, very experienced campaigners.
Oh, that's got to be close. Oh, interesting contest. Mahanamar's pretty quick, so's Deepak Patel. But I think that was a little bit risky, that run.
I'm going to take those singles. You call immediately without hesitating first. It certainly would have been a line ball.
Beautiful shot. A shot that Mahanamar has played extremely well right throughout this series. None for 14. Beautiful shot. Brendan Karupu. None for 21 after 5 overs. Danny Morrison is on at the beach end. In the air, and a brilliant catch. Martin Crowe on the left hand. I think he predicted that almost. When he saw Mahanamar going for that shot, he was on the move in that direction. It was Karupu playing away on the onside. And I think as soon as he saw him going for the shot, he was heading in that direction.
Fantastic catch. Diving away to that left hand. They either stick or they don't. On that occasion it did. Sri Lanka have lost their first wicket, 1 for 24.
Guru Singha comes in at number 3, as he has done since the first match. He opened in the first match over in Perth, but since then he's come in at number 3. And he comes in to replace Brendan Karupu. Brilliantly caught by Martin Crowe.
Karupu had made up his mind that any ball that was pitched up was going to go. Not bad tactics. Unfortunately not coming off there.
Richard Hadley has decided he wants a crack from the Church Street end. That is an excellent delivery. And Richard Hadley is struck. Guru Singha seems a little surprised by Earl Johnson's decision. But was certainly a very confident shout. And Guru Singha has been given out, caught behind from the bowling of Richard Hadley. Well, it did look like a bit of daylight there. He certainly got a hell of a shock when he turned around and saw the finger up. All that matters is what's in the book, and it's 2 for 33. Aravinda De Silva arrives at the crease, arriving in the commentary position, Bill Lurie and Richie Beno.
Richard Hadley, the bowler. Well, it's just a question of whether the edge of the bat found the ball, as well as the noise coming from his bat striking the inside of his front pad. Safely away, and it'll beat Chatfield. Certainly wasn't where Mahanamar meant it to go, but you don't always worry about that.
The intention was clear. He was looking to hit it over mid-wicket. It's got a fraction late. Got enough bat onto it to whip it square for four.
Ewan Chatfield has been brought back in place of Richard Hadley. Safe and four.
How often do you see when a batsman has an injury or two? Changes his tactic. It's the first sign of aggression. Aravinda De Silva, it was a beauty. Sure, it was in the air, but he hit it with tremendous power. Well over the Talbot point. Four valuable runs.
Mahanamar, he's still out there, their batsman. The work ahead of them. Their bowlers did well early. Maybe the good work early was wasted a bit later in the innings.
Deepak Patel. Well, that's a beautiful shot, straight down the ground. One bounce over the line. It's an aggressive reply to this bowling change.
Mahanamar got himself off to a great start, throwing the challenge to Deepak Patel. He's now got something to think about. Four off that first delivery, and it's a huge hit. And immediately we see one slip back to deep mid-off.
Well, he's hooked that one away. This could be out. He's got... Oh, no, he's dropped it. Gillespie down there, getting behind a straightforward sweep shot. And somehow it went straight through his hands.
Certainly a very confident stroke. Hit it as well as he possibly could. Perhaps lunged a little bit.
Looks as if Gillespie, having just dropped a catch, is going to be asked to make up for that by bowling somebody out. Oh, that's a good shot. Smashed away. Backward of point for four. We better have another look at that one.
There's no doubt about seeing the white ball here. Aravinda De Silva, the little pocket dynamo, unleashes a magnificent shot. That's brought the crowd to the edge of their seats.
Oh, he's hit that one square. It's in the air. It's going down towards Gillespie, this time wide of him. And one bounce into the fence. This is... an aggressive little spell. I'm not too sure that these Sri Lankans aren't enjoying off spin. They face a lot of spinners and they look very comfortable against them.
So I think facing spin would be just like going to primary school for Sri Lankans, particularly a spinner in the class of Deepak Patel, just a part-time spinner really. Jeff Crowe really looks like he needs an Aspro at the moment. No runs. Headaches in the field. Gillespie dropped a catch. Then a disastrous over. Deepak Patel, he went for four. Very first over, first ball of his first over. And now in the second over, under pressure already.
That's six. He smashed that over the top of mid-wicket. Into the crowd. And what a lovely shot that was. Well, tangles, they caught them in Adelaide, they caught them in Sydney, but these Tasmanians can't catch the sixes.
Well, they haven't seen a white ball down here very often, Tony. This is the first time, the inaugural game here at Bellerive Oval. Perhaps the background's a little worried, but you called that right off the bat. There was no doubt where that was going, straight over the fence. What a hit.
So these two have got to move on. That's four more. Just brought a man from the mid-wicket region inside the circle. That gave the silver the scope to go that way. He did it well.
Yes, this is a favourite shot of Aravinda De Silva's, the front foot pull shot. And you've only got to be a fraction short and bang, it's gone.
Danny Morrison take up the attack. Oh, shot, sixth shot of the match. He loves to play the pull shot. We saw him do it in Adelaide, which I think is one of the best shots of the season. And that also was a beauty.
This crowd here at Bellerive have really taken the Sri Lankans to heart, and they're getting more and more excited with every shot. That was an absolutely brilliant shot. I reckon they're going to go berserk if Sri Lanka win this game. Beautiful shot.
Out in the centre, Ewan Chatfield has taken over from Richard Hadley. Must be out. Yes, he is. Now, that is bad luck. But it's the break New Zealand needed so desperately. Ewan Chatfield kept his head there as Mahanamar lost his footing. Mahanamar run out for 58, the end of a splendid innings.
Well, that's the part that fate plays. Very unfortunate for Mahanamar. That is a tremendous innings. He'd been there. He opened the innings. He's put together 58 fantastic runs, but the Sri Lanka have lost their third wicket for 136.
Three for 150, Sri Lanka. And Sri Lanka are ahead on run rate at the moment, and that's important with the rain falling here at Bellerive Oval. Here's Richard Hadley, this time from the beach end. In the air and out. Ratatunga goes and Hadley is struck, and that's what New Zealand so desperately wanted. They've got to get wickets and they've got to get the Sri Lankan run rate down as well. Hadley has started them on the way. Ratatunga out for 11.
Vice captain of Sri Lanka. Getting the leading edge straight to mid off. And that's really what New Zealand require. They've lost their fourth wicket now with 151 runs on the board. As the captain of the Sri Lankan side has arrived in the middle, his job will be to continue the good work done particularly by De Silva and earlier by Mahanamar.
Aravinda De Silva taking strike. The batsman crossed. It's just outside off some post, I think.
That, I think, is a professional plea for a wicket. The ball just pitching outside the line of off stump and hitting the pad just outside the line of off stump.
Gillespie is now into the attack. It's in the air, but into the gap. Very good shot. He can play them all around the wicket. And that certainly brings up his 50. 1-6 and 5-4s. And well played, Aravinda De Silva.
Big crowd here. Really have enjoyed the exciting manner in which this little fella has gone about his cricket.
Saranjom Namudagully, the captain out there. Keep things nice and calm. He's had 24 balls for his 10, and he's batting with Aravinda De Silva, who's batting beautifully. Rutherford is going to continue. Oh, he's gone and done it. He's hit it straight up in the air, and he's gone. Well, oh, the wheel's going to fall off Sri Lanka at this late stage. He's not very happy, Ranjan. out, caught by Wright at mid-on, trying to force the ball over the onside.
A dreadful shot, hitting right across the line, splicing that one up in the air. This stage of the match, certainly not necessary. The easiest of catches to Wright. Sri Lanka's captain now to Pats. And they're 5 for 167.
Ravi Ratnayake is out there. And Mudagully wouldn't be very happy with this one.
Rutherford would. But I think Mudagully will watch this one on replay. And he is very much committed to leaving early.
It's a big moment for the Sri Lankans. They've been on a hiding to nothing. And all of a sudden, they're with a big chance in front of a good crowd.
That'll help them. Got it past the keeper and past Gillespie for four. That's a very useful boundary.
And Jeff Crowe, six inside the circle, seven inside the circle. Rutherford found the edge. Just beat Ian Smith.
Beautiful shot, that one. Well, there might have been a bit of luck about the previous boundary. Not that one. What a good over for Sri Lanka. And now, I think we can safely say they're skating home to victory. Ewan Chatfield getting under it. And he's grabbed it just by the fingertips. That was really a silly shot because Sri Lanka had the game all wrapped up. And I suppose that you must give a little mark of credit to the skipper, Jeffrey Crowe. He's got all the field up, induced him into playing a rash shot.
Well, when you get a rush of blood and you loft it, you'd want to pick out Ewan Chatfield. He's not a great mover, but he never takes his eye off the ball. This was a superb catch. Enormous pressure, just into the cupped hands, holds it high. The silver departs, and New Zealand still in this match. 6 for 185.
And a bit of a coaching lesson there from Ewan Chatfield. Maybe Stuart Gillespie swapped him. A catching lesson for a bowling lesson.
Yes, this was a fine catch. Vinny De Silva played well. Got a little bit excited, I think. And Chatfield took a well-judged catch. At 37 years of age, it's not easy. He's caught it as clean as a whistle.
Five runs required for Sri Lanka's first win in this competition.
Ball.
No ball called there by umpire Johnson. That ball was out pretty early. Didi Alvis took full advantage of the early no ball call.
Yes, he's a very strong hitter through that region. I don't think the call would have made any difference because he likes it when it's a fraction short. Hits through it. Mid-wicket lunge, but couldn't get a hand to it.
Just two needed for Sri Lanka's 14th win in limited over international cricket. Well, there's more of the Sri Lankan team now crowding out to witness this victory, coming out into their outside area. Beautiful shot. That's an excellent shot to bring up victory. So they've made the 200 required for victory in the 47th over, and that is an exceptionally good win to Sri Lanka.
Yes, their bowlers did the job early. They had New Zealand 5 for 70, and despite a 95 run partnership between Blaine and Richard Hadley, They restricted New Zealand to 199, but it was never going to be easy. There was a bit of movement in the wicket. But the young batsman, De Silva, played a steady knock, concentrated hard, was tired down, but they never lost their cool.
That was a great performance from the Sri Lankans. They made it, not without a few alarms, I can tell you. And I reckon the panic's on out there at one stage and also in the dressing room, but they got there, and that's the main thing. They've registered their first win in this competition in 1987-88. The card of their innings, 6 for 200. Just at the end, a little flurry between Ravi Ratnayake and Guy D'Alvis. 21 not out to Ratnayake, 7 in 5 deliveries to Guy D'Alvis, and 6 for 200 from 46.3 overs. The outstanding performance, though, came from Mahanamar, who made 58 before being unluckily run out. Unluckily in the sense that he slipped, but it was clever work from Ewan Chatfield to gather the ball and run to the stumps with it. Karupo out for 12 and Gurusinghe for 5. Aravinda De Silva played a lovely innings for 55 before he was needlessly out. Very good catch by Chatfield, running away to his right at mid-on. Rotunga 11 and Madugalli made 10 from 25 deliveries. 6 for 200. And the bowling figures for New Zealand. Ewan Chatfield, 10 overs, 1 maiden, none for 30. Richard Hadlee, even a losing side, 10 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 22. That's a great performance. Danny Morrison didn't bowl out his 10 overs, just 8.2 for 36 in the wicket. Stu Gillespie, 9 overs, no maiden, none for 47. And Deepak Patel was the problem because he had 25 taken from 3 overs, and then the rain came, and because he's a spinner, he couldn't grip the ball, so Ken Rutherford had to bowl out 5 overs and no maiden, none for 25. But a great moment for the Sri Lankans. They played it well, they bowled well this morning. If you can forget the number of no balls and wides they bowled, they've still got a problem there. But at least it's got them 2 points on the Benson Hedges World Series Cup table, and it was a terrific effort from Ranjan Madugalli and his team. 5 played, 1-1, 4 losses and 2 points, and they're up over 4 with their run rate. So they could just be making a little charge and making New Zealanders feel nervous at the moment. The Australians are on top with the game in hand, 4 played, 6 points and 4.92 their run rate. And after today's loss, New Zealand, who incidentally were without some of their very best players, John Bracewell couldn't play, Martin Snedden couldn't play, and nor could Andrew Jones, because they're all injured, and that was a crushing setback for Geoffrey Crowe, the skipper. 6 points for New Zealand and 6 for Australia. So a very good match here, the 7th in the Benson Hedges World Series Cup. We look forward now to the game between Australia and Sri Lanka, a day-night match in Melbourne on Thursday. That should be a very good game. The Australians keep saying they're not intending to take the Sri Lankans lightly. And following that game, there's a doubleheader in Brisbane. So this Benson Hedges World Series Cup is taking shape now. The Sri Lankans today have thrown everyone's ideas into disarray by defeating the New Zealanders at Belrive Oval, the first big international game ever played here.
This has been another presentation of Nine's Wide World of Sports, your Winter Olympics network.